There was some concern, George, about a deceleration in billings. At one point, the stock Thursday down 11%, biggest drop since November. Others on the street saying nothing to dislike in this earnings report. What was the most important point for you?
Well, I think when you look at the earnings report, you've got to start with we exceeded all guided metrics. In addition to that, we actually had record revenue, record gross profit, record operating profit, and for the first time, GAAP profitability. So when you put all that together, it was extremely strong. And the way we run our business is not by billings. Billings is more of a timing issue. You have to look at net new ARR. And if you look at the current environment with the current conditions and macro headwinds, we think it was an absolutely strong quarter, and it was a beat and raise. And I think it's a testament to the product and the customer base that we have.
Let's talk about that net new annual recurring revenue. First year over year decline amid what is, of course, as you say, a challenging macro environment. Is that macro environment improving in any way that the perspective you're seeing? Is it getting easier in the sales cycle or no?
Well, it's certainly not getting easier. When we looked at it, it remained consistent and consistently challenging. It's something that we've talked about, the headwinds for the last couple of quarters. We didn't see it get better, but we saw it remain basically the same. So we'll see what happens for the upcoming quarters. And obviously, everyone's hoping for some relief with interest rates and some of the debt ceiling issues, but that remains to be seen.
The clients that you're signing at the moment, what are they most focused on? I'm pretty sure everyone's thinking about generative AI, about some of the risks involved in cloud, which adoption is still strong there. What is the number one priority for the clients that you're currently serving?
Well, it starts with stopping breaches, which is why I built the company. And I certainly believe we're the best at it, and I think our customers would say that. But when you put that aside, the number one driver really is consolidation. In the current environment, everyone is looking to save costs and consolidate. And with a platform that has 23 modules, we can create a very compelling ROI and a payback within the first year. What that means is we're taking share from other vendors, and we're consolidating it onto our platform.
George, when we spoke at RSA in April, AI was the buzzword for everyone in your industry, both as a tool, but also recognizing that threat actors have access to the same technology. Now you've got a partnership with AWS. How did that come about?
Well, AWS has been a great partner for many, many years. They're also a customer. And when we looked at what we were doing, what they were doing with Bedrock, we thought it was a great partnership. We protect a lot of their customers and their clouds. And when we think about AI, you talk about RSA, we were both there. It was all about AI. Guess what? CrowdStrike's been doing this since 2012, when I started the company. That was the bedrock and the foundation of why I started it. Now, AI has transformed over time. You've got generative AI, which we're excited to talk about, Charlotte AI and what we're doing in that space. But AWS has certainly been a great partner for us, and we look forward to advancing that relationship.
George, what I increasingly hear in the C-suite, conversations I'm having here in Silicon Valley, is technical expertise is the driver within a company. Who within your organization was pushing you to basically say, what can we do with Amazon? How can we build something within Bedrock? I want to know how day-to-day a company like CrowdStrike brings LLMs into their existing offering.
Well, it's a great question. And the good news is there's not a lot of pushing. It's actually built into the DNA of the company. That's the way we started it. That's the way we protect against these adversaries using AI. When we think about generative AI, we started this project some time ago as LLMs were starting to mature and come to market. So we have a group, or many groups actually, but we have a particular group in Europe. In fact, I was out in the office when we launched Charlotte AI, our AI expertise and center of excellence. And we basically said, how do we do this at scale? How do we partner with someone like AWS? And how do we come up with the best outcomes for customers? And one of the things to keep in mind is you have to have the best data set to come out with the best outcomes.